Hi, and welcome to this edition of Bobcat Update. I'm Kristen Euler.
And I'm Michael Ellis. Today, we'll tell you what local voters can expect when they head to the booths, and what the city of San Marcos is planning to do to prepare you for natural disasters. A Louisiana congressman says Michael Brown showed a lack of concern for Katrina victims. Representative Charlie Melanson posted several of Brown's emails on his website Wednesday. He says they show Brown's failures as head of FEMA. Melanson and Virginia Representative Tom Davis requested the emails from Director of Homeland Security Michael Chertoff. Davis is chairman of a House committee appointed to find out what went wrong during Hurricane Katrina. The Department of Homeland Security has not released a complete list of Brown's emails.
San Marcos residents will have an opportunity tonight to learn how to prepare for natural disasters. The Council of Neighborhood Associations is holding a special presentation this evening at the San Marcos Activity Center. The presentation will emphasize the importance of being prepared in case of heavy rains, which can then lead to widespread flooding and even spawn tornadoes. There is no specific season for bad weather of this kind in Texas. That's why city officials are encouraging residents to be prepared. Weather officials describe Central Texas as Flash Flood Alley because some of the worst floods in Texas history have occurred in this region.
Voters can expect a few changes for next week's election. There won't be any more punch card ballots in Hays County. All voting will be done electronically for the first time in a local election. Hays County adopted the new system as part of President Bush's Help America Vote Act. The law requires that all punch card voting booths be replaced by a more up-to-date method by January 2006. The Hays County Elections Administrator says the new process is just as easy, if not easier, than the old process. She says she thinks everyone will be able to use this system.
More changes are in store for Texas State as it attempts to stay competitive in the education marketplace. LaShamba Randall has more in this Bobcat Update.
Some departments have new names and new buildings are being built. The mission at Texas State is to be a premier university dedicated to educational excellence.
It was a top-down, bottom-up process where the president was leading the university and there are certain things that we wanted to accomplish. So we came up with 6 goals for the university.
Much has been accomplished in the first year of a 5-year plan. The Round Rock Center has a new building with state-of-the-art facilities. 22 new faculty positions have been added university-wide, and Texas State has been granted doctoral programs in criminal justice, computer science, mathematics, and math education.
The university's strategic plan is now in its 2nd year, and as a part of that plan, the building you see behind me in progress will house the McCoy College of Business, which is expected to open in spring 2006.
The McCoy family pledged more than $20 million to the business school to ensure a quality program. Some students feel the changes will help the university earn nationwide recognition.
The more recognized the campus is, then the better our degrees will look. Whenever employers are looking at us.
The mission statement is reviewed every 4 to 6 years. For Bobcat Update, I'm LaShamba Randall.
Coming up on Bobcat Update, we'll tell you about a new and unique way to get a flu shot. Stick around.
It's getting late. And you? Are walking on campus alone, but you don't have to walk alone. You can pick up the phone and call 245-SAFE to request a safety escort provided by the Texas State Police Department's very own Bobcat Bobbies. Your Bobby will meet you where you are at with their signature Bobby vest and golf cart to safely take you to your car, dorm, or anywhere else on campus. The Bobcat Bobby Safety Escort Services are available to students, faculty, and staff from 7 in the evening till 2 in the morning, 7 days a week. All you have to do is pick up the phone and call 245-SAFE. A safety escort with the Bobbies is like having your own personal Superman to escort you home. To arrange for your safety escort today, call the Bobcat Bobbies at 245-SAFE. That's 245-7233.
Welcome back. The San Marcos Fire Department might be moving pending the results of Tuesday's election. Proposition 3 is on the ballot, and if passed, it would fund the construction of a new fire station. Fire officials are urging voters to pass the proposition, saying the current location on Hutchison Street is too crowded, which hampers emergency responses. The current station was built in 1968, when the city was much smaller and traffic congestion wasn't a problem. Officials haven't decided yet where a new station should be built.
Just drive through and get a flu shot. Austin's first ever drive-through flu clinic was held yesterday at the Travis County Expo Center. For a $10 donation, the elderly and people with disabilities didn't even have to leave their cars to get protection from the flu season. The one-day clinic started giving shots at 9 a.m. and shut down around 1 in the afternoon. A little more than 300 people took advantage of the drive-through. Austin health officials say they expect to be doing it again next year. If you're a Texas State student, the health center will be giving flu shots at the LBJ Student Center Wednesday.
New studies show that exercise doesn't have to be strenuous to be beneficial. Andrea Robinson has more in this Bobcat update.
Health officials are recommending a new way to meet the 30-minute exercise requirement. Adults are encouraged to accumulate 150 minutes of exercise a week by stringing together small amounts of physical activity throughout the day. Physical activity doesn't just mean participating in an organized fitness program. To meet the 150-minute goal, health officials recommend doing everyday activities like shopping or just getting off the bus one stop early. 30 minutes of moderate activity most days of the week can lead to significant health benefits,
which is lower blood pressure, lower cholesterol, lower stress level, lower chance of disease like heart disease, breast cancer, any of those. That's what it's going to affect.
It's simple math. Add up bits of daily activities until you reach a sum of 30 minutes. But if weight loss is your goal, health officials recommend 60 minutes of exercise a day.
30 minutes isn't giving you enough time to depreciate the calories that you're taking in. A lot of times weight loss is calories in, calories out. So if a person is bringing in an overinflux of calories and they're not able to make a deficit by exercise, they're going to have to go longer. So that's why they're suggesting the 60 minutes.
While some physicians say 60 minutes is an admirable goal for weight loss, such a standard can scare off those for whom even getting off the couch is a challenge. But in terms of health, you don't have to join the gym to gain the health benefits from exercise. For Bobcat Update, I'm Andrea Robinson.
Buy a house, get a free bride. That's the deal one Denver woman is offering. Deborah Hale placed an ad on eBay offering to sell her home to a compatible man she can spend her life with. For about $600,000, a 40 to 60-year-old man can buy a house in a trendy neighborhood that comes complete with a bride. Hale also has her own website outlining the deal. She says she has gotten about 60 responses. Hale says she's looking for her soulmate. The deadline for bidding is Valentine's Day, 2006.
You know, I might be eligible for that if that $600,000 was a little negotiable. You know anybody in the running?
I don't know. I've had this professor for about 3 years. Dr. Niekamp, he might be able to get the job
done. That's all the time we have for you today on Bobcat Update. Please join us next week. We'll be back then.
I'm Michael Ellis. Have a good evening.